Hello, fellow human. Welcome back to another Doggo Reddit / Choosing Beggar video. On to the first story. Mom asked for old phone as temp for uncle. Offered old phone. Can't be too old. Has to be iPhone 6 or above.
Do you have any old cell phone?
Why?
For Donna Dodd until his phone arrives.
Oh, I'm not sure I have a working phone, Mama. I have some very old phones that work, but he'll need SIM card adapter.
He doesn't need very old phone. Has to be iPhone 6 or above.
Hello? Excuse me? When did I become a phone store? Pretty bold of your mom. Hilarious response. On to the second story by /Merlay2. I'm somehow got lowballed on a free couch.
Hello, I can help you with this Chesterfield if no one wants it because of the COVID-19, but I will charge you $80. Thanks.
Wow, I didn't think that was possible for something for free. It just shows how low people can go. The third post by Coniver, how to respond to choosing beggars.
How much will you charge me?
Full price? What do you mean?
I was hoping, since we are cool, you would hook me up with a discount, lol.
Why? In order for us to be cool, I gotta be the one hooking you up. Why don't you hook me up with the full price plus a tip since we're so cool? Yeah, that's the whole point. If you're truly cool, you pay to support the ones you support. The fourth post by Blue X Cat. Ask for free, got it. Wants free delivery too. Venting. I was selling a Minnie Mouse dress from Disney World on the marketplace. A woman messaged me and asked if I would donate to her for free because her daughter's needs closed. I gladly agreed. And then she asked me if I would drop it off. I simply said no. She then proceeded to say,
"Well, I hope you never have to beg someone's for clothes for your cat.
Like WTF, I was going to give it to you for free." I tried to explain to her that I do not have a vehicle and a low income myself and that she was being very rude. But she blocked me before I had the chance. Some people are just so ungrateful. And rant. Well, I guess that her daughter doesn't really need a dress. The fifth post. Her soon-to-be ex-husband is an attorney, and she is an employed. Would we see the same expectation if his client offered to pay with their out-of-the-world baked goods?
The following examples, I think, may be more of a difference in our culture. In my church community, this kind of bartering is commonplace and accepted. She is not religious, so I think she isn't familiar or comfortable with the idea. So, I asked ... if she could do my divorce as she is a lawyer. She said she doesn't do family law but gave me the name of a friend who does family law to call. I didn't want to pay for a lawyer because they are super expensive. So I called his assistant and asked if he could do my divorce and in exchange, I would bake him some freshly baked goods. My baking is out of this world, seriously. I left several messages and he never got back to me. So I asked ... if she could call him and find out why he hadn't replied. She sort of put me off and never really responded. So I kept asking her but gave up after she wouldn't commit to calling him. I guess she told our friend she thought it was entitled to expect this lawyer who didn't know me to do my divorce for free. Even though it wouldn't have been free, I was offering him baked goods. Again, this kind of battering, I'll paint your deck and you give me the casserole, or I'll look after your cat while you're on vacation and you bring me back some spices from Mexico is very common in my community, so I didn't see anything wrong with that.
I love how she's equating a service worth thousands of dollars to watching a cat or painting a deck. On to the sixth post, GTFO, but also good day.
Is this still available? I want $10.
Well, it's $15.
Okay.
And yes, it's available.
I want, it's new, right? Question mark?
It's not new, but it's in good condition. It was 40 new.
How old is it?
About a month. My dog is just too big for it.
Can you bring?
Well, no, sorry.
Where are you?
Here's my address.
I don't know where that is. I'm on dot dot dot.
If you look at Google Maps, you can find it. It's on dot dot dot.
What is the address?
Same address.
Can we meet at a random store?
No, sorry.
Why? Why not? It's too far out.
I'm sorry.
Send me the address and I will see how far out.
Send the same address again.
That's on the ghetto side of town.
Lol, okay.
GTFO sticker. And then freezing sticker. But then good day sticker.
What I found funny is that he communicated like a toddler. These 7 posts. My spouse used to be a CB until recently. My spouse, male, 28 years old, used to be a really, really bad CB. We will call him Tim. Tim grew up in another country where bargaining and lowballing merchants and sellers is a very common practice. And it's something that he would still try here in the US. For example, he likes purchasing used items but only wants top quality / name brand items. He will make a decent offer to the seller. Then, when he picks the item up, he starts with the begging.
Would you please be willing to take half of the original price? Come on! Both me and my wife are just poor college students. I'm sure I could find it newer and cheaper elsewhere.
Finally, he changed when our car's transmission went out. He's been going to the same mechanic ever since he came to the US 9-ish years ago. Tim, as always, tried to negotiate with the mechanic over the price. At one point, basically starts begging. The mechanic is actually being very patient and is explaining that a new transmission is simply a pricey part. And Tim only wants a new transmission. He's not willing to buy a used one. So Tim threatens to never return there and that he'll go to the competing mechanic instead. Of course, no shop is willing to match the mechanic's quote, much less offer him anything lower. So he sucks it up and returns to the original mechanic, and mechanic flat out turns him away. Surprisingly, Tim offers to pay more, mechanic apologizes but firmly says no. Ever since then, he has been much more conscious about respecting people's prices and negotiating appropriately. Well, I like the mechanic refused his business because she was so sick of this. The 8 pose.
Can we have this for free? My son is in a wheelchair.
When I was around like 10 or so, I broke my ankle during youth football. I could walk with my cast and crutches, but my dad had me ride in a wheelchair in most public places. Being a kid, I loved being pushed around wherever I went. It was like going on a ride every day. Looking back now, though, I see my dad's new sense of entitlement came from. Ironically, my dad didn't believe I was hurt at first because he was so focused on me winning the big game. He even blamed my injury for costing my team the win. However, I think once he saw his injured son in a wheelchair, his face lit up as if the song "I Got a Golden Ticket" was playing in his head. My dad took advantage of just about every handicapped perk he could find, parking spots, bathrooms, ramps. I remember some passers-by stopping by and saying things like, "Oh, you poor thing. Oh my gosh, what happened?" My dad was surprisingly cheerful when he explained what happened. I couldn't tell if he was exaggerating to make me seem stronger than I really was, or to make himself seem like a brave dad protecting his helpless kid. Before long, my dad started using more underhanded methods to use me as a prop. I remember early on to my recovery, my dad took me to Walgreens to get some medicine. But he also got a bag of candy, a toy car, and a miniature Get Well balloon to go with it. I was excited that I was getting all of these treats. And then, the scene that played out similarly to the ice cream parlor scenes from Zootopia. Cashier. Well, that will be insert dollar amount here. My dad looked around his pockets for a minute. Dad, Gosh darn, I left my wallet at home, to me. This has got to be the worst recovery day ever, huh, kiddo?
Cashier, I'm so sorry about this, sir. I can hold your items if you want to come back later.
Dad, go come on now, have a heart. You really gonna tell my kid he can't get these treats when he's in this condition?
Cashier, I'm sorry, but I can't just give away our inventory to kids that are handicapped. My dad just kept arguing with the register, getting more angry by the second. Some other parents complained that we were holding up the line. My dad ended up saying something like,
"The customers is always right,"
before we headed out with only my medication. I wasn't so sure if I liked being in a wheelchair anymore after that. My ankle fully recovered by fall. TLDR, entitled Dad Uses His Handicapped Son to Guilt Trip a Pharmacy into Giving Him Free Toys and Candy. It doesn't work. Oh, wait. How did he manage to pay for the medicine if he didn't have a wallet? The 9 Post by U/Wallflowery. Buyers are asking for everything in the house we are selling to them. So right now, my parents are selling a condo for a bigger one as they're heading toward retirement. This condo is a second home, and I use it for college even. They managed to get an offer pretty quickly from a young couple that are just starting out. As we're closing the sale though, they ask if we can throw some of the furniture in for free. We agreed, but this eventually snowballed into asking for everything. As in, the spices, the dishes, the paintings, the kitchen appliances, heck, even a remove your shoes sign. They wanted so much stuff, the realtor eventually just sent a list of the things they wanted from each room so we can see it and cross off the items we don't want to give them. Some of the stuff was mine from college. We cross off anything that was basically new or good quality items we want to take to the next place, such as the smart TV, the Roomba, some dishes that had sentimental value, stuff like that. We just got a reply back from the realtor today, and apparently they want us to reconsider not giving the TV and the Roomba. What is crazy is that we were already giving them a pretty nice wireless vacuum, and they still wanted the Roomba. This is thousands of dollars worth of stuff we're throwing in for free, as they are taking all the furniture except for my desk and chair, and they are still asking for the handful of items we want to keep. The realtor says we should keep in mind that they are just starting out and they don't have anything. My dad doesn't care and just wants to get a new condo quickly. My mom is pissed. We might just give them a TV that is an older model but bigger since it's just being stored at a friend's house, 50 inches but not a smart TV. Well, personally, I wouldn't have given anything for free. You can state in the offer what you will leave for free, and that's it. The 10th story, trying to return a jacket while it's wearing it. I work in a clothing retail chain and like most stores, we have a return policy in which you can return items within 30 days as long as they are unworn and still have the original tags. I once had a customer walk in wearing a jacket who then proceeds to take it off and put it on the counter and find the original tags from the bottom of her purse. She told me she bought the jacket a few days ago, but realized she already had something in that color. I told her that I couldn't process the return as she'd clearly been wearing the jacket and it's not in the right condition to sell it to the new customer. She then asked me if she walks out the store and comes back in not wearing the jacket, that we could pretend this never happened and she could return it. I firmly said no, and she storms off in a huff. Like, what? Oh, you just gotta love the idiots, especially the cheap ones. On to the 11th post by Buttercup 1995, entitled Mother Wants Me to Sing Her Child to Sleep. Since the lockdown has begun, I've got into a habit to take a walk on the terrace of our building after I finish off work. I'm still working from home to get some sunlight. Yesterday, I saw M, who lives in the next building on their terrace. Our buildings are close together since we live in the society and our galleries are right in front of each other, so we know each other fairly well. After a short hi, hello, she started complaining about how it is so difficult to be a mom. She gave birth in February. We'll call the baby B here on. How she has had no sleep in the last few months and barely gets time for herself. M. It must be easy for you. You have no one to look after, and since you still live with your parents, they must be looking after you. Why don't you help me look after B?
Me, I'm not exactly free, you know. I live with my parents. That doesn't mean they still look after me. I'm working and have to help around the house too.
M. That is nothing compared to looking after a child. You should help us to put her to sleep. My husband and I don't get enough time for ourselves because B keeps crying all night. I've heard you sing. You have a sweet voice. Sing her a lullaby and she'll fall into sleep instantly. Shouldn't be a problem for you. I've seen your lights on even after midnight.
I am shocked at this point. She is asking me to look after her child at night so she gets time with her husband? Me, sarcastically. Okay, how much you'll pay me?
M, pay you for what?
Me, you'd pay a babysitter or a nanny if she was looking after your child.
M, we'd pay a babysitter to look after B in our absence. We will be there, so why should we pay you? And we don't want to hire you as a nanny. You have no experience. You looked after B and you have some experience. You could work as a nanny if you want.
Me, I'm an engineer. Why would I give up a high-paying job to become a nanny?
M, then just don't be a nanny then. Just look after B to help out your neighbor.
I just told her I have no time and I left. I don't see how someone can be so delusional to ask someone to work for them to help out your neighbor. Why would you have a child if you can't look after it? I really hope she doesn't make a fountain out of a molehill. Ooh, I would be very hesitant to be inside their place. Very creepy. The final story by CKD36. Shared apartment laundry machines. Okay, so I'm gonna go on a little rant on here instead of yelling at my good-for-nothing neighbors. Alright, now for some needed backstory information. I have lived in my apartment complex that has 4 units, a building for 3 years. All 4 units share the same washer and dryer in the laundry room. Well, for the last 2.5 years, I have no issues with my neighbors at all with sharing them. We all kind of have an unspoken sense of what days who does their laundry, since we have all lived here for a while. Well, we have had some new neighbors move in, and they never do their own laundry. But when they do, they specifically use my laundry detergent and dryer sheets that I leave upstairs. And I have not once said anything, even though I know it's them, since I haven't had a problem with it before. Well, long story short, today I started my laundry. As I have since the dawn of time done my laundry the same day and the same time. Well, my neighbor thought it would be a good idea in the middle of the load, take my laundry out of the washer and dryer and starts theirs. Not to mention, she had to get past all 3 of my baskets to do it. Oh, and the best part was, I left enough quarters upstairs to switch it. You can already guess that she took them. And yes, she did. I did confront her about this, and she said she needed her laundry done, and I was too angry to speak with her, so I left it alone, because I'm a very nice person. At least I like to think so. But today was the last straw. So today, in spite of her, I took my laundry detergent back down and will be keeping it with me from now on. And I left her a gift, change laundry detergent with a mix of bleach and red dye coloring. Well, that is my little rant for today, waiting on what the reaction will be when she uses my gift. Also, I apologize for any grammars or spelling errors. I was mad and rushing through this. Well, I definitely support this pettiness. A lot of people dreaming about getting revenge on their neighbors, but never go through with it. You are some people's heroes. That's it for today, fellow humans. Thanks for watching. Be sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. See you guys next time.